three more organs left. What have we discussed so far? We've discussed the UN General Assembly, we've discussed the UN Security Council, and we've discussed the International Court of Justice. Then fourth, we have the Economic and Social Council, or the ECOSOC. You can write down Economic and Social Council. ECOSOC Council. Okay. So this is one council which we don't read about in news very often. Okay. They don't come in news, but they are important in the sense that a lot of these specialized agencies, initially at the beginning of the class, we saw that there are two sets of institutions that we'll discuss. One is the organs, six principal organs of the UN. The next one is specialized agencies. Now, a lot of the specialized agencies report to the Economic and Social Council. Okay? And as the name suggests, they are all dealing with issues of economic and social importance to member countries. So you can write down Economic and Social Council, the first point, as they deal with socio-economic problems of member countries. Then you can write down many UN specialized agencies report to the Economic and Social Council. Okay? So they report their findings, they report their programs, the results and everything to the Economic and Social Council. Okay? So, it's one of its main functions is to look at these reports. Okay? To analyze these reports, and they can also suggest policies. Policy suggestions. Policy suggestions to various programs of the UN. They can suggest them to the General Assembly. So that is another function of the Economic and Social Council. And under this we have 54 members. 54 members representing the Economic and Social Council. They are elected by the General Assembly. Elected by the General Assembly based on recommendations of what is it? Yes, Security Council. Recommendations of Security Councils. Okay. So, and under this, there's a particular division that you can write down. Among these 54 members, 14 are from Africa. Okay. 11 are from Asia. 6 are from Eastern Europe. This is another region. 10 are from Latin America. 10 Then we have 13 from Western Europe and other regions. So this is the split up. So when you add, you get 14 plus 11 is 25, plus 6 31, plus 10 41, plus 13 is 54. Okay, so we have 54 members who are elected by the General Assembly, and they are elected on the basis of their regions. Okay, different regions of the globe. So we have Africa, Asia, Eastern Europe is one region. Then we have Latin America and Caribbean. That is South America, Caribbean region, Central American region. Then we have Western Europe and other regions. Okay. So when you talk about Western Europe and other regions, you have US and everything coming under this. Okay. So that is the thing under Economic and Social Council. Then you have different regional commissions under Economic and Social Council. Economic and Social Council is the head, and you have different subordinate councils or commissions working under it. They work under different regions. Okay, you can note them down as well. But they are not according to these regions, they are different regions. So you can start with the first one. Economic and Social Council, you can write ECOSOC Council for Africa. First one. So you can write ECOSOC Council for Africa, and its headquarters is in Ethiopia. Okay, that is your first regional council. Then you have Economic and Social Council for Asia Pacific. Whose headquarters is in Thailand. Okay. Then Economic and Social Council for West Asia, whose headquarters is in Jordan. Okay. Jordan. Then you have the Economic and Social Council for Latin America, whose headquarters is in Chile. Okay. Then at last we have Economic and Social Council for Europe, whose headquarters is in Geneva. Okay. Geneva is in which country? Geneva is in Switzerland. Okay, and you will observe when we study about specialized agencies that a lot of them have their headquarters in Geneva, because Switzerland has always been a very neutral country. It does not side with any extreme nations. It does not side with any extreme ideologies. They are a neutral country. Therefore, all important UN specialized agencies headquarters are situated in Geneva, which is in Switzerland. Okay, so with this we are done with the Economic and Social Council as well. Now we have the UN Secretariat. Okay, you can write up. So any doubts so far? It's going okay? So you have the UN Secretariat. So UN Secretariat is nothing but a body to take care of the day-to-day administration of United Nations. You can write up for day-to-day administration. Of the United Nations. And it's headed by the? Yes, the Secretary General. Secretary General of UN. And yes, the General Assembly is also headed by the Secretary General of the UN, that you can know. Who is the present Secretary General of UN?
Antonio.
Very good. Antonio. Who is he?
Portuguese.
Yes, he was the former Portuguese Prime Minister. Okay, former Prime Minister of Portugal. Okay, he is now the present Secretary General of UN. Okay, so that is with regard to UN Secretariat. You don't have much to discuss under this. Then finally, we have the Trusteeship Council, the last organ trusteeship council. Have you heard about this council anywhere? Have you seen it in news? There is no chance because it was suspended in 1994 itself. Suspended in 1994. Because its main function is to act as a trustee for the non-sovereign states. Okay, you can write down to administer. Its main function was to administer non-sovereign states. So what do you mean by non-sovereign states? Yes, what do you mean by sovereign? Yes, independent, to be exact. So you say independent country, which has internal supremacy and external independence. So when you talk about non-sovereign states, it refers to all those countries which are not independent yet, or which are undergoing some sort of problems, or are still under colonization, which are still colonies of some other countries. We call them non-sovereign states. So we know that by 1994, most of the states, most of the countries had become independent. So the purpose of this council was done. It was not relevant anymore. So it was suspended in 1994 itself. So trusteeship council was formed for that purpose, to take care of the non-sovereign states. And so now we do not have the trusteeship council. UN Secretariat, we've discussed. So this brings us to the end of United Nations organs. Any doubts?
Official languages.
Yeah, official languages are there. There are five or six official languages, I guess. English.
Arabic.
Yes, English, Arabic.
French.
French, Chinese, Russian, and English. Arabic. Mandarin, I guess. No, Chinese or Mandarin.
Chinese.
English, Arabic, Chinese. I'm not sure. I forgot. I referred to English, Arabic, Chinese, French. Spanish is there, I guess. Spanish and Russian. Spanish and Russian. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can just Google UN official languages. See if it is correct. This is just correct. It's fine. So I guess these are the official languages of UN. Any other doubts? Anything to add on? I will look at those members again and I will let you know, which was that UN Security Council, right? And you know, there was some confusion.
International Court of Justice.
Non-permanent members. International Court of Justice also we had a confusion.
In that only we had confusion.
I thought Security Council. Non-permanent members. ICJ has 15 judges. They're both permanent and ad hoc judges. And 15. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. In 15, some 9 majority is what I think. 10 non-permanent members.
Huh? Another question that she was asking, like, non-permanent member can be a judge.
That matters. I noted that. Non-permanent member of
can be a
they can be a judge or not. Those who accept the jurisdiction of ICJ. Second one is,
I think this is done. Should we disconnect it for something?
Mm-hmm.
Switch off the camera so it's